It's time for the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour with, from the Facts of Life, Mindy Cohen. From Newhart, Tom Poston. Fred Travelena. Nedra Volz. From Falcon Crest, Kate McGeehan. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Sometimes the stagehands are strong, and sometimes they're not so strong. They pull those doors open. Do you think that's mechanical? There are two guys pulling on ropes back there to open those doors.
And at the moment the door was supposed to open, the guy was saying to Gene, he says, I'm going to get this right today, Gene. I'm getting this right. The other guy already gave the cue. Perfect.
Here we are. Are you all ready?
Yes.
We have a new kid on the block.
Yes, gorgeous
What
girl.
Can we do for her to make her welcome?
Give her a kiss, Gene.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Thank you. Kate, you've never done it before, and you're going to have a good time today.
I'd like to match that.
You'll have your chance.
Not with her, with you.
Check with me later. Now let's greet our two players over here. We have Chris Wickers and Gail Redman.
We're going to find out a little bit about each of them, beginning with Chris. Tell us about you, please.
Hi, I'm from San Diego. I live in San Diego. And I recently graduated with a bachelor's degree. I'm now working as a registered nurse. I love outdoor sports.
And what did you get a bachelor's degree in?
Bachelor's degree in science, nursing.
Right.
Right.
Say, now is the time for all good men to come to the aid of the party.
I couldn't.
Say, a quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
Quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog.
You sound like a tape recorder. You're cute, Chris. How about a little kiss? No, I'm only kidding. Hello, Gail.
Hello.
Tell us about you, please.
I will. I'm from Durango, Colorado.
Yeah.
Beautiful Durango, Colorado.
Pretty place.
I am married. I have two small children, Crystal, who is 6, and Andrew, who's 3. And my husband and I just celebrated our 12th wedding anniversary.
Well, best wishes to you.
Thank
Congratulations.
You. Thank you.
All right, let's play the match game, shall we?
Great.
We're going to play 3 rounds. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Chris won the toss, and she'll go first.
B, please.
Okay. Jack said, they're doing some underground nuclear testing in my neighborhood. My poodle just turned into a blank.
How
round one question. Anything that comes to your head. Anything goes here.
How grisly.
All right. Now, Chris. Jack said they're doing some underground nuclear testing in my neighborhood. My poodle just turned into a blank.
My poodle just turned into an elephant.
An elephant? I said it was a difficult one, didn't I? Very difficult. This is a hard one. What do you say?
Well, maybe we could start another round, Gene. See, all the jokes about glowing in the dark and so forth, I had the poodle turn into a light bulb.
Okay, that's one possibility. All right, Fred.
Hi, this is Michael Jackson. I'd like to say hello to all the girls in the balcony. I love you. Well, when the bomb went off, my dog was out getting his bone, and he turned into a glowworm.
That's a good one. We expected all kinds of wild responses. Kate, how wild did you get?
Well, a French fry.
A French fry.
That's cool. A French fry. I like it.
That's good.
Thank you.
Very good. So far.
That could end any moment, Gene.
Yes.
I said a cat.
Dog turned into a cat. Oh, boy, that's good.
Mindy.
I warmed him up for you, Mindy.
Thank you very much. Well, I saw the day after. That,
yeah.
So, and it burned people. And it, so I said, hot dog.
A hot dog.
That's good.
Good.
That's a 10.
That's the best. That's the best.
Mindy, it's not only a good answer, but it's a you injected a note of humor into it, which we're really looking for, and we thank you for that. It's nice to have you with us. Hello, Nedra.
Hello. I'd like to start out with a real brilliant answer, but I can't. So I said a lady's muff.
A lady's muff.
I don't understand it either.
Well, that's a furry creature.
That's good.
I understand it.
It's lovely.
That's getting to be my problem. I'm beginning to understand your answers.
It's excellent.
Waldo said, Waldo. I'm beginning to think that the irrational inquirer doesn't print the truth. This week's cover story is about Helen Hayes having an affair with blank. Okay. Go, Tom. He has a rubbery body. Hello, Gail.
Hello.
Wallace said, I'm beginning to think that the irrational inquirer doesn't print the truth. This week's cover story is about Helen Hayes having an affair with blank.
Michael Jackson?
Michael Jackson. I guess you all got the idea. What we were after here is some unlikely person, an unusual
combination. Yeah, that would be slightly unlikely for both of you.
Yes.
Well, maybe it's because the talented and charismatic Fred Travelena put the idea into my head, but I actually said Michael Jackson. Oh,
all right, Fred.
Now, on the other hand, I, who should have said it, didn't say it, huh?
You didn't say
How
it.
How about that? But what I did say, I went really, really far out there, and I said, Dreamy Smurf. Hello, Papa Smurf.
Dreamy Smurf. Small and blue,
hands. That's unlikely.
Talented and charismatic.
What came
Fred
to your mind?
Forgot to take
oh,
his own
boy.
Advice.
Well, it's the best I could do. President Reagan.
President Reagan.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I don't know. I think that's in the ballpark. All right, John boy.
I'm afraid I took this just that one little step further, and I said, Boy George.
Good one. You like that one?
Yeah, I liked it so much. That's what I put, Boy George. Uh-huh.
You liked it too, Nedra?
Well, I liked it, yes, but I didn't say that. I have to stay with my own group, you know, and I said Gary Coleman.
Gary Coleman. Gail, you pick up one. Chris has yet to score. That's in a round one. And round two will be along right after this. Now, here we go to round two. Gail, you're ahead. You go first.
I'll try B, please.
All right. Nino said. Nino.
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 Nino. Nino.
Paisano, Nino. He said, I lost my accordion. Oh. But I don't miss it. Now I make music by squeezing my blank in and out. All right, here we go, Gail. Nino said I lost my accordion, but I don't miss it. Now I make music by squeezing my blank in and out.
I don't know how tacky these people will get, but buns.
Okay. We got a raunchy crowd over here, but I don't think you're going to get that raunchy. Just for laughs, did you do one?
No, I didn't.
Oh, okay.
No.
All right. Fred, I thought maybe you were going to try and get a laugh for it. Love your tie, Fred.
Well, thank you, thank you, thank you. You know, this man is Italian, yes, Nino?
Yes.
That's a good answer. I'm a toad of buns. Then this fella help me out. I say the sister. I squeeze my sister in and out.
Yeah. That'll make a noise.
Yes, some noise. Thank you.
What do you say?
I say he's a Tommy.
Tommy.
Tommy, yes.
All
yes.
Right. That's a good one. Getting close, Gail. So far. All right, John.
Do you like my tie? I'm just trying to change the subject, Jayne. I said, wife.
That's okay. Yeah. Not bad.
Yeah. I couldn't agree with you more.
Yeah. You know, it's possible it may be a rotten question. That's always a possibility. Mindy?
Yeah.
Thank you. All right.
Yeah, John and I match again. I said wife.
Wife. Nedra?
Yeah, come on.
Bed springs.
Hey, there's a good one. Bed springs.
Bed springs?
Very good.
You're like, yeah. Oh, bed springs. That's good.
I tell you, there's a little delayed reaction here because we're in a different studio and somehow the audience is like they're in Pasadena and we're out here. And that's why it's a little late. Now, Gail, you stayed at one. And, Chris, let's see what you do with your round two question. Jill said, that psychiatrist chased me all around his couch. I told him I thought I was a chicken, and he hollered, whoopee, I think I'm blank. You're all looking at me dumbfounded. Psychiatrist chased me all around his couch. Right. I told him I thought I was a chicken, and he hollered, whoopee, I think I'm blank.
Got it.
You got it? We about all set over there?
Yep.
All right, Chris. Jill said that psychiatrist chased me all around his couch. I told him I thought I was a chicken, and he hollered, whoopee, I think I'm blank.
I think I'm a rooster.
A rooster is good, Chris. Very good. A tough one, but she came up with the right answer, or one of the good answers.
He was feeling cocky, and he said, I think I'm a rooster.
Uh-huh. 1-1.
Well, it's all a question of what you want to do with the chicken. He said he was Colonel Sanders.
Colonel Sanders. Uh-huh. All right. So we've had the two good answers, two of the good answers so far.
Colonel Sanders.
Colonel Sanders, there it is. What do you got, John?
I'm about to concoct one of the most amazing matches in the history of this show, Jayne. And you will be there to witness it.
John Bauman and...
I said, Foghorn Leghorn. Aha! He's a rooster! What? Up! He's a rooster! He's a rooster!
Hold on, what did you say?
Ace. He's All a right. specific rooster?
Oh, the years is generic and a rooster is specific.
No, there's the buzzer. Vice versa.
I mean, vice versa.
Vice versa. His is specific.
Right.
This is
This is Howard Cosell. Never have I seen such anger in the eyes of an audience.
All right, Mindy.
Yes, I said Colonel Sanders.
Colonel
He's
Sanders.
Colonel.
Looking for a plain old rooster, Nedra.
It's a plain old rooster in love.
All right. Round two. 2-1 is the score. Third and final round, right after this for our friend. Okay, here we go with the third and final round. Chris, you're ahead. You'll go first.
A, please.
A?
A.
You sure? All right. Here it is. One of the biggest attractions in London is the changing of the guard. Now, Nerdocrumbesia, that's our mythical, fake, tacky, dumb country. Mm-hmm. Nerdocrumbesia is such a strange country. Its main attraction is the changing of the guard's blank.
I don't write.
Lay it in there. No, you match in the previous round.
I don't write.
No, you don't.
What am I doing?
All right, here we go. Chris, you ready? One of the biggest attractions in London is changing the guard. Nerdocrumbesia is such a strange country. Its main attraction is the changing of the guard's blank.
Changing of the guard's horses.
Horses? Do they wear horses?
Excuse me.
I'm sorry.
You're really making her feel great, you know. Well, they do change horses, you see. So they
don't they?
That would not be so. You know. Mm-hmm. Occasionally they ride a different horse. I don't
know. I heard that horse. I heard that horse.
I don't know if you're going to score with that, but we'll find out right now, beginning with Fred.
What's the name of that country again?
Nerdocrumbesia.
Nerdocrumbesia, yes, sir. In Nerdocrumbesia, when they change this particular item, what you hear for several hours is... Underwear.
Underwear. What are you going to change for us, Kate?
The famous underwear.
Uh-huh. All right, Kate. John, what do you have to change for
us? I was going to fix up my last answer and say it was the changing of the guard's rooster, but I did resist that. I thought that the most subtle and fascinating answer, a real late 60s answer, was the changing of the guard's mind, you see.
Ah.
But I didn't say that. I said, in fact, underwear. My people.
All right, Mindy, she's saying my kingdom for a horse. What do you say?
I didn't go as far as underwear, but I said pants.
All right.
A little Nedra? Yay. Okay. I can deal.
Hello, Nedra. You don't play.
I don't
you match
play
in the previous round, much. So now we go to Gail. She's ahead by one, Gail. That means you need one to tie or two to win, which puts you in a pretty good position here. Old Lady Purvis said...
What'd she say, Jeff?
Purvis?
I really like older men. I just love them. The only problem is all the men older than I are blank.
Give it to him. You don't play.
Music.
That's
like
good. That's a good one.
As you went up the river towards the town,
right,
natives.
Here we go. All right, Gail. Old Lady Purvis said, I really like older men. The only problem is all the men older than I are blank.
Dead.
Well, you've certainly scored a hit with this crowd. What a bunch of weirdos. Screaming and applauding for death. What
well,
do you
she
got?
Said dead buns.
Oh.
Well, you know, this is George Burns, and I have the same problem with the girls, you know. And that's why you can't date anybody older than me, because the same thing, they're dead.
Dead. Ah. Score is now tied 2-2. One more cadaver and you win the game.
Of course.
Oh, dear. Pooped out.
Pooped out.
That's not exactly
that's
the
okay
same. It's not exactly oh, the same.
All right. No, it's not exactly the same. John?
I couldn't quite finish my writing here. It's really unfortunate before the buzzer rang. But you will be happy to know that I said dead, but they've been reincarnated as roosters.
All right, so Gail wins the game. Right there, if you would, please. Now, Chris, we're going to say goodbye to you and send some gifts to you from the match game. Chris Wickers, ladies and gentlemen, there she goes.
Hello there. How are you doing, Gail?
Good. Now, we're going to switch over to Hollywood Squares. We'll bring in the rest of the set and the other stars, and John and I will trade places. And we'll have a lot more excitement coming your way. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Calvinator No Frost refrigerator featuring 3.6 cubic foot freezer, meat keeper, dual Christmas trim wall insulation, and ice maker capability furnished by Calvinator. It's time for more of the match game, Hollywood Squares Hour with, from We Got It Made, Tom Villard, Jayne Kennedy, from St. Elsewhere, Terence Knox. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares, John Bauman.
We'll be back to play Hollywood Squares in just a minute. Don't miss it.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
He doesn't mind. What's his name?
Larry.
Larry, you don't mind. I know it's your 12th anniversary, and I have my arm around your wife. But she's just done so well. She made it through the match game, and she's going to go on to play Hollywood Square. So, congratulations. She's getting it from all sides, this woman. Okay, and over here we have three brand new celebrities. Tom Villard is with us. Jayne Kennedy. And Terence Knox. And Jayne Kennedy, last few times you've been here on our show, we have discussed your exercise program. Mm-hmm. You have a book and a record and all kinds of stuff. Yep. And this time you wanted to say something about your exercise program.
We have a success story right here in the studio with us. Mindy just told me this morning she just started on the program, the Love Your Body program, and she just lost 7 pounds.
Yay, Mindy! Yay!
Well, congratulations to both of you, Mindy.
It's fun. I recommend it for everybody.
Mm-hmm.
I do.
And congratulations to you, too, Jayne, on this success. Let's hope you have some more success here in Hollywood Squares. Gail Redman, here we go. And we will reacquaint ourselves with our defending champion. Her name is Jin Houston Ati.
Right.
She has a total of $1,050. Congratulations. Yay. Hey, did I get all your names right?
You got it right, Dan.
It's your second day on the show, so why don't you just remind us about your life to date in 25 words or less.
I'm a recent graduate from California State University in Northridge. I'll be attending dental school in Nebraska in the fall to become a maxillofacial surgeon, and I'm happily married and wonderfully in love and living in Moore Park.
Poor gal. Happily married, wonderfully in love. I got a lot of dentists in my family, you know. We'll have to discuss this, but we'll discuss it after we play Hollywood Squares, which we will play until you hear the Time's Up bell. At that point, someone will go on to play Supermatch. That can be worth up to $30,000. You haven't got into the big money yet, but maybe today will be your day. Gail may have something to say about that. First game is worth $100, $25 for every square. Jin Husanati, pick a star, and let's go.
I'll start with Fred, please.
Fred Travelena.
Yes, I want to make her feel at home. She wants to be in the dentistry.
Okay.
Fred, if the post office wanted to, could they put Richard Nixon's picture on a postage stamp? Or does he have to be dead first?
They better put my picture on a postage stamp. You know, I want my picture on a postage stamp with a meat flavor on the back. It'll be nice.
I think they has to be dead in order for that to happen.
He says Nixon has to be dead before he can get on a postage stamp. What do you say, Jin?
I disagree.
Nixon has to be dead first. No, you should have agreed with Fred, and your opponent gets the first square. They usually wait at least 10 years after a person's death.
What about the stamps of the little birds and the deer and stuff? Are those dead, too?
Or the Olympic stamps, you know, the ones with the long jumper.
Were the Olympic people on? Yeah.
They're gone, man.
You know, the Olympic stamps?
Pick a star, Gail Redman, for an O.
Terence
Knox.
Wait, do it this real slow, because this is my first question today.
You must have just impressed her with your ecological statement, Terence.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now, not to change the subject, but what's the BVD in your BVDs? Is it the initials of the manufacturer? Or does it mean boys' ventilated drawers?
Yeah, what are my options again? Tell me that again real quick.
Okay, BVD either is just the initials of the manufacturer or it stands for boys' ventilated drawers.
Initials of the manufacturer.
I agree.
It is, in fact, the initials of the manufacturer. Yeah. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get another square. They are Bradley, Voorhees, and Day. Jin. Pick a star for an X.
Jeanne DeBlock, please.
Critical position early in the game. You missed this one. Gail takes the first one.
Oh, no.
Jeanne Rayburn, who invented swim fins? Buster Crabb or Benjamin Franklin?
Benjamin Franklin was not noted for his athletic prowess. The only thing he was good at was chasing older women, and he did that with alacrity. So he certainly didn't invent swim fins. Buster Crabb, who was an Olympic champion and a record holder, a world record holder, a world-class athlete for many years, I suspect he did.
Jean says Buster Crabb invented swim fins. Agree or disagree, Jin, to block?
I agree.
Swim fins were invented by Benjamin Franklin. You should have disagreed with Jayne. Your opponent gets the square and wins the first game in a clean sweep. Ben Franklin did it. So, Ben Franklin was the weirdo I saw in Hollywood wearing swim fins and flying a kite. We'll be back with a 200-dollar game right after this. Be there.
For more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. And now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. So I guess Richard Nixon's not licked yet, and neither is Jayne Husinati, because even though she dropped the first game, she's going to start this one, and it's worth $200. Pick a star.
I'll start with Fred again, please.
Fred Travelena, and whoever else may be present.
Today it's John Hausman. Want to announce a brand new laxative product called the Paper Chase.
John.
Yes, John.
In Japan, is it still possible to get a job as sword polisher to Emperor Hirohito? Or did that position disappear with samurai warriors?
Still get that job.
He says it is possible to be sword polisher to Emperor Hirohito. Agree or disagree, Jayne, for the first square?
I agree.
Emperor Hirohito? Hirohito? Yeah. Bring in the relief co-host, will you? Emperor Hirohito does, in fact, have a sword polisher. Yes, you were right to agree, and you get the first square. Sure, doesn't everyone? You're on the board. Gail Redman, pick a star for an O.
I'm going to go with Terence again, please.
A brave woman. Terence Knox, who has more sex partners during an average year? A 30-year-old single man or a 30-year-old single woman?
Oh, man.
Be careful. Be very careful.
How
That's the difference
Terence?
Between what I would like to think is true and what I know is the truth. The man.
He says a 30-year-old single man has more sex partners. Agree or disagree, Gail?
I agree.
A 30-year-old single man it is. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. That's he kind of keeps you honest. Jayne, an X and an O, and an X for you. Where would you like to place it? Pick a star.
You don't know any 30-year-old.
I'll try Tom Poston, please.
Hello.
Hi there.
Yes, I'm ready.
Tom Poston.
Yes.
You're 7 months pregnant, and you're very excited about becoming a mother.
Excited? I'm beside myself.
That's one of those sex partners, see?
Now, according to the American College of Obstetricians, is it okay to relax in a hot tub, or is that not recommended?
Depends on how hot, but I believe in a hot tub, don't do it.
Okay, so it's not recommended to relax in a hot tub if you're 7 months pregnant. What do you say, Jayne?
I disagree.
It is not recommended. No, you should have agreed with Tom. He knew his stuff. Maybe he really is 7 months pregnant and excited about becoming a mother. All right.
I haven't started to show yet.
That was a bit of a break for you, Gail, because there's another O on the board.
I'm
place
carrying
one on your
high.
Own.
I'll go with Kate, please.
Okay, Kate McGeehan, first time ever in Hollywood Squares. According to the Leather Institute, is the leather made from the south end of a northbound cow the softest leather on the cow or the toughest?
It is on the soft end of the cow.
So that leather on the cow's rear end is the softest leather on the cow. Agree or disagree, Gail?
I disagree.
It is the toughest leather, and you are right to disagree, and you get another O. Well, it's a suspenseful $200 game, and the suspense is about to increase because we're going to break for a couple of minutes and be right back. See ya. $250 for the challenger and only $25 for the champ. Come on, champ. We're in our third segment now, so you got to get something going. Make your move.
Nedra to block, please.
You missed this one. It's really going to be a pretty big lead for the challenger. You're an average 1984 Lincoln Mark 7 automobile.
I am?
Trust me, Nedra.
I've been called a truck, but I've never been called a Mark.
Now, this Lincoln Mark 7 automobile has just been recalled by Ford for a problem. Do you have a sagging rear end or creaking joints?
I have a little of each. I think you have a sagging rear end, if you're recalled.
Nedra Volz says those recalled cars have a sagging rear end. Agree or disagree to block, Jen?
I agree.
They have a sagging rear end, and you are right to agree. You get the story and you do block. And that was important at this point in the game, without a doubt. Gail Redman, you are thwarted in that position. Pick a star.
Tom Villard to block, please.
Thanks.
Okay, the shoe is on the other foot. Gail needs this one to block.
I'm ready.
Which of these is on display in the Smithsonian? Fonzie's jacket or Dolly Parton's bra?
It's a two-parter, isn't it?
A loaded question.
I would guess it's a tasteful institution. I wouldn't think that they would display a bra without, I don't know, coloring it in or something. So I would think that it would be his jacket over apparel as opposed to under a garments.
Agree or disagree that Fonzie's jacket is on display?
I agree.
Fonzie's jacket is on display in the Smithsonian. You get the square, and you do block. Hey! Dolly Parton's bra would be double D! Jen?
Jean Rayburn to block, please.
All right.
Let's hear it for Jean Rayburn!
Yeah!
All right,
Jean.
But it doesn't mean we don't like Jane.
This is important now. This is for a block. Okay, you missed this one. Gail has a really big lead. Are American buffaloes moving closer to extinction, or are they making a comeback?
No.
Thank you.
Little more.
American buffaloes are well protected by the National Park Service. As a matter of fact, you can even get them and breed them yourselves. They'll lend you some. So there are plenty of buffaloes.
Man, who wants to breed with a buffalo anyway?
Right.
Jean says they're making a comeback, American buffaloes are. Agree or disagree to block, Jean?
I'll agree.
American buffaloes are making a comeback. Yes. You're right, Jerry, you get the square. And you do block. The board's filling up, Gail. Pick a star.
Jayne Kennedy to win, please.
She couldn't block you there. For the game.
Oh, no.
Is a baby rabbit born with fur, or is he naked?
Oh, the pressure of winning. Let me see. Baby rabbit. Have I ever seen a baby rabbit?
Yeah.
No. No, I would naturally think that they are born with the fur. It's all wet and everything. It may look like it's skin, but it's furry.
She says baby rabbits are born with fur. Agree or disagree for the game, Gail?
I agree.
Baby rabbit is born naked. Oh. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets the square and blocks you there. So the situation has evolved where we have a completely full board. Only one place to move. Jen, pick a star.
Mindy to win, please.
It's as simple as this. You get this one, you win the game. You miss this one. Gail will win on the basis that she will have five O's on the board.
No pressure at all. Okay. Thank you. Mm-hmm.
Those were just the facts of life, Mindy.
But I'm bummed. Yeah.
Now, according to a 17 magazine poll, 17 magazine, she is the most admired woman among teenage girls today. Is she Princess Diana or Cindy Lauper?
I would have to go with Princess Diana. I mean, it was such a fairy tale story. So I would say Princess Diana.
She says Princess Diana is the most admired woman among teenage girls today. What do you say, Jen, for the game?
I agree with Mindy.
Princess Diana it is. You were right to agree, get the score, and you win the game. Congratulations. congratulations to you, but congratulations only on that game. Other congratulations are premature. We got a very close one going. $325, $275, $50 difference. Sweep the X's and O's off of the board. Let's keep it moving. It's very, very tight. Gail, pick a star.
I'm going to go with Terence again.
Terence Knox.
Yeah.
Your pet elephant is acting up.
What's he doing?
Can you actually send him to an elephant obedience school, or is there no such thing?
There is such a thing.
Agree or disagree, Gail?
I agree.
There are elephant obedience schools. Yes, you're right to agree, and you get the square. The bell means that time is up. She has done it second day in a row. Jin Husanati is our champ. We're going to be sending Jin to obedience school right after the show. But before you go, just zip your way right over there and join Tina and send me a shot at the big money. We have one very happy woman, and I'm afraid one not so happy one. You played really well. It was as close as you can get, a $25, meaning one square difference. Our congratulations to you, Gail Redman. You're leaving here with $300, and our thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you. Bye. Thanks.
All right, Jayne, your move.
Here we go with Champ. She's really excited and all hopped up. Let's tune in a minute or two and see if she wins the big one, the $30,000 and the Super Batch.
Play the Super Match is Jayne Rebber.
Okay, Johnny O. All right, Jin is up here for the second time. She's going to have a go at the Super Match where she could win $30,000. How do you feel?
Oh, wonderful.
You haven't got it yet.
Yeah, well, that's all right.
Oh, all right. Well, let's find out if she's going to get it. We'll begin over here. We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Dead blank. If you give us the answer they wrote down most often, we give you $1,000. Then for choosing the second most popular, $500, $250 for the third. Any three of the nine stars are allowed to offer a little assistance here.
I'd like Mindy, please.
Okay, one of my favorite authors, Stephen King, Dead Zone. The Dead Zone?
It was all right, Dead Zone.
Tom Poston.
Tom.
I'll say Duck.
Dead Duck.
John.
John.
Yeah. There are still some good ones left. I'll say Dead End.
Dead End.
Oh, that is a good one.
Okay. So you have Dead End, Dead Duck, and Dead Zone. Now you have to think it over carefully and choose one of those, or you may want to give us one of your own invention.
I think Dead End sounds good.
Dead End? All right. Famous play on Broadway many years ago, Dead End, and we'll find out if it's up there. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $250 response. Deadhead.
Deadhead, sure.
Deadhead. All right.
Boom. Go Jerry Garcia.
The $500 response says, dead or alive.
Yeah.
I what do you think?
One too.
I better get it.
You better get it?
Come on now.
It'll be there.
Okay.
Come on, kids.
All right, here we go with a $1,000 response. Slide it, Steve. Hey. There's the big money. Okay.
I'm surprised myself.
I'm not.
Very good, John. Now, we're going to play the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing, and after you've made your decision, we'll ask the star to reveal the hidden number. There are four tens up there, four twenties, and somewhere there is 130. And none of us really knows where it is. And I don't know. The producer doesn't know. It was all done by some little gremlin. Where is it?
I'm going to try Tom Poston.
Tom Poston may have the number.
I reveal this, right?
Set. Go.
Come on, let's go.
A 20.
That's good.
A 20. You're playing for $20,000.
I'll do the disclaimer.
20,000 bucks at stake here. Here we go. District blank. D-I-S-T-R-I-C-T. District blank.
Now I have to say mine. She has to say
you write yours down and put it in the slot.
Oh, okay. I was writing down multiple choices. I better write down one, huh?
Yeah, just one.
Okay, I got her in the slot now.
All right, Tom's ready, Jen. You match him, you get the $20,000. What do you say?
District Attorney.
District Attorney. Why do you think Tom is hiding his head?
Tom, I'll kill you.
Now, there's a friendly contestant. You don't get the right answer, I'm going to kill you.
Why do we go to somebody else? Go to Jean or Jayne. Jayne or Jean. I said the District of Columbia.
District of Columbia.
I once lived there, so I never lived in District Attorney.
Well, there were two. District of Columbia and District Attorney were the two good responses there. Listen, you've added to your winnings a little bit. You picked up some in Hollywood Squares. You picked up another 1,000 here. That means you got $2,375. Okay, we'll be back with Jayne and the Stars right after this. Here we go now with a big reveal. I want to find out which of the stars had the one big number that's up there. Would you all pull at the same time? Ready,
yank,
set,
go!
Oh, oh, brother, I'm not even going to tell you what I would have said.
What would you have said?
You had the 30.
What was attorney, sure. 30,
yeah.
Sure.
Well, it was one of the two good
in that case, but they were both good.
Yeah.
And listen, didn't that contestant coordinator tell you you're supposed to show a little emotion?
I'm trying.
You're doing a great job.
Okay, Jayne, we'll see you tomorrow. Jean Rayburn invited you to join us tomorrow.
John Bowman saying so long for the match game. Hollywood Squares, Jayne Husanati Hour.
A member of our studio audience will receive Duquesne's Gas Grill and a colorful cabinet, American made, featuring three burners, two for grilling, one for assisting, and a steel cooking grid designed to hold heat more efficiently, furnished by Duquesne. Due to a production error in Hollywood Squares, a question was replaced in the program edited. This is Johnny Olson speaking for the match game Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Productions.